Hi, this is Rachel with Good Behavior Beginnings, and today we're going to talk about 5 tips for a successful homeschool day. This is part of the open collaboration with Rooted in Rest and the Waldock Way, and I will link the playlist in the description. So tip number 1 is get enough sleep, and that is both for the child and for you. We all function better when we're well rested, and it helps the child to be able to be ready to learn. It helps us to be able to be ready to teach and to deal with all of the other challenges and variables that come up during the day. Tip number 2 is to establish a routine, not necessarily a schedule. It doesn't have to be time-based, but that there's a routine or a rhythm that you tend to engage in that can make things more predictable. So we start with our morning work. Technically, we start before that with hygiene, and then we come downstairs and we do our morning work. And then we move into some of the more hands-on activities like science and art. And we generally end our school day with Spanish and math because those are computer-based. So establishing that routine, make things predictable. Then you know what's coming next. The kid knows what's coming next, but we don't stick to a specific time schedule. And by having it more as a routine, it's can be more flexible in case things do need to change. Offer choices is tip number 3. As many choices as possible that you can give to your learner can allow them to feel more in control. Now, with homeschool, I think that our learners often do feel like they have more of a say on things than if they were in a public school with 20, 25 other kids. But even within those activities, there are things that we as parents are deciding and choosing what's next, or that the curriculum has outlined we want to do this in a certain way, or if you have to report grades, there might be certain things that you have to do periodically to report back to your school districts or the state. And having choices for the learner about maybe where they want to sit while they work on certain things, or, you know, do they want to use a pencil or a pen or marker, a dry erase board? Do they want to narrate and you videotape them as opposed to them write it? As much flexibility and choice that can be built into those activities can help your learner feel more in control and less likely to push back when you do say, all right, we have to do this way because of X, Y, or Z. Tip number 4 is to take breaks. not just when things get frustrating, but before they get frustrating. We found that around 10:30 or so, we just need to take a break, and we have a snack break. We get some applesauce or granola bar, and we just get up and we move around a little bit. It makes the rest of our homeschool morning go smoothly, and it helps to refocus. Taking those breaks when, you know, prior to them being at the point of frustration, but then also taking breaks when things are frustrating. You don't have to power through things. One of the joys of homeschool is that you can have that flexibility and adjust the timing of things. And if you don't get to it right now, or if it takes longer than anticipated, there's no bell schedule that you have to go on to the next activity at a certain time. So taking those breaks when you need them, before you need them. And, you know, that may also be taking a break from school for a day or two or a week or two. If everyone's feeling burnt out, you're not going to learn anything if everyone's frustrated. So taking those breaks when you need them is really beneficial. And my 5th tip is don't be too hard on yourself. I don't know about the rest of you, but I did not envision myself homeschooling but we're here because of the pandemic. So we're enjoying it, but it's not like we had years of time to plan for this. It kind of fell into our lap and we said, okay, this looks like the best option. And we're figuring out as we go along. So give, you know, be gracious with yourself. Don't be too hard on yourself. Don't be too hard on your kid too. You know, this is new. If this is new to you or even just what you're covering that day, it's new, it's different. And we're doing the best we can. So those are my 5 tips for having a successful homeschool day. And please share your suggestions and check out the other videos on this collab. Thanks.